How do you value life? Do you consider yourself equal to others? To all living and breathing creatures? Or do you consider yourself more powerful, better, more respected and deserved? Why do you think so? What is your reasoning, if you've ever given it a thought? Does your life equate to the life of an animal? Will you kill another to satisfy yourself? Now let me ask you a question. Do you eat meat?
What made you decide to become vegan?
I became vegan purely for ethical reasons. I've watched so many videos and documentaries about animal cruelty and torture and what goes on behind doors in the slaughterhouses. And for me, it just doesn't make sense to keep eating animals if that's how we're treating them. I've been vegan for almost 2 years, and to be honest, I love it. Like, I wouldn't go back because I know that I'm not harming something else in order to eat food. Like, I know I can just do it like ethically, responsibly, you know, without hurting anyone. There's pretty much always a vegan alternative. I feel healthy, like I have energy. So that's the main reason why I became vegan.
So you value the life of animals in the same way that you value the life of a human?
Oh, of course. What's the difference between your pet and the food that you're eating? Like, where do you cross the line? It just doesn't make sense to me that you can eat one thing but then have another animal as a pet. No reason, no thinking, like, for me at least.
So with that, has there been any challenges with public opinion and misconceptions of veganism?
Yes, very much so. Especially in my family, because nobody in my family is vegan. Like, I kind of introduced everyone to that. I just let people know why I'm vegan, why I do it, in the hope that maybe that plants a seed in them for them to do their own research about veganism. People have lots of reasons for doing it. Yeah, so how I deal with the scrutiny, okay, well, these are the reasons I chose this lifestyle, and that's that. I have done it in the past where I've tried to force it down people's throat, and that's not a very effective approach because people just shut down and turn away from you. Like, they don't want to hear it. They don't want to hear that they're murderers or hurting, like.
Me. Bundles of flowers away through the hours of cold. Winter shall howl at the walls, tearing down doors of time. Shelter as we go. Promise me this. You wait for me only, scared of the lonely arms. Surface.
My name is Greg Barth. We run a beef property here. We have a bit over 500 acres. And we run about, at the moment, about 400 head of cattle. mostly breeders and heifers. Yeah, this farm has been a family farm since 1905. The family dairied here, and we finished dairying in 2010, and now we just run beef cattle. At the moment we run about 150 to 200 breeders, plus the heifers, and in the next few years we hope to get those breeder numbers up to around 250 to 300 breeders. We think there's a pretty good future here. It's a nice lifestyle, and we like it here. This was a family farm. It's been a tradition. I'm the fourth generation to work on the farm, and there's our children are the sixth generation that's lived here. It's in our blood, I suppose, and we like the farming life, and it's challenging sometimes, but it can be very rewarding as well. Being a family farm and rearing most of our animals ourselves, we do get a little bit attached to them. We see them go from being born through to cows that then have their own calves, and we look after them as best that we can. If we look after them, they also look after us and serve us well, so we like to take care of our animals. Obviously, we as beef producers, we're not vegan or vegetarian, but I can see that's beliefs that some people have, and I think there's definitely room for both sides of the argument. We believe we look after our animals well. Our animals don't get harmed, they serve a purpose, and there's room if people want to be vegetarians or vegans. Well, I don't have a problem with that personally myself. It's just not the path that we go down. Sometimes there's comments out there from people that anyone that rears animals such as us are cruel to their animals. We're not cruel to our animals. We look after animals. Their animals are nice and quiet. We definitely think there's a place for what we do and a need for what we do. Yeah, I guess in industries where they're in intensive farming and in sheds and stuff like that, if some people see that, I suppose they have a belief that that's how the whole industry is, and that's far from the truth. The biggest majority are farmers like us that their animals are out in the paddocks and well looked after and nice and quiet and do very well. Yeah, at the end of the day, what we do here as a farm is a business. And it's run as a business, but we do look after animals as well, and the bottom line isn't the be all and end all. When times are tough and that, dry conditions and that, we have to sometimes, it costs us more to keep looking after our animals than what we can make out of them, but we have to look after our animals, and if we look after them, they look after us in return when the times are good.
Bundles of flowers away through the hours of cold. Winter shall howl at the walls, tearing down doors of time. Shelter. promise me these. You wait for me only, scared of the lonely arms. Surface.